Hello there, and welcome to the Hungarian Grand Prix. 12-5-1-2 again. We have a pretty, dominant car, they say now. Leclerc was close to second, though, but he has a penalty, which means Bottas will be moving up to third, which is quite impressive from the Alfa Romeo, both of them in Q3, Pierre Gasly in 10th. Verstappen also will be taking a penalty, which means Gasly will probably move up two. Depending on how many penalties Leclerc takes, he might even move up two spots, so going to be a bit interesting. There's three other people taking penalties. We will most likely be able to just get away with one or two penalties for our cars. One probably for Duhan throughout the season and two for Piastri due to his crash. So we're actually looking quite good. Now with that in mind, we'll be setting up a strategy and we're actually having a wet race. Nope, we're not. I got lied to. I saw rain. We could do this, but again, it's a passive strat, I feel like. Going more aggressive could benefit us. But we're going to invert this strategy and start on the mediums. Start on the mediums, and then we're going to do softs towards the end. And of course, we'll be pushing all race, basically, so we'll have to see how we can make this work. I think this looks good. 23.55... And we'll just copy this for Duhan, I think. It should be alright. Starting on the mediums, hard, then softs. 55.23, wasn't that what I said? I think so, let's just check. Looks good. So yeah, they'll both be on the same strategy. We'll be pushing again. It's just the best way to run your car if you can get clean air in front of you. Well, not clean air, as long as you don't get bogged down by slower drivers. It is currently... Again, I feel the best strategy by far. So hopefully we get both off the line safely. We should. But you don't really have any guarantees. So let's get the race started.
It's sunny and... This is it! The Hungarian Grand Prix! And it's lights out! And away we go!
Now, did we have a good start? I think so. Looks like we're good. We kept our positions. Now it's just, can we get, the gap made? That's really the only thing. Sainz has overtaken Bottas. Not really a big surprise there. But the Alfa Romeo is looking good, so we'll have to see if they'll challenge for some points there towards the end. Gap has been established, more or less. 3 seconds, basically. Let's go neutral, and let's also balance fuel. And we're just going to allow things to progress quite aggressively here, because we have reached a point where the races are going to be a bit boring, sadly, but it's just how it is. I'm uploading all of these for in case you find them interesting. You don't need to force yourself to watch all of them, in all honesty. But, yeah, we have found a trick that works. We are using said trick. And again, it won't work unless you can actually create this this pocket of ours. So Piastri is currently running a bit low on fuel. It will be okay for the time being. We'll have to turn probably fuel usage down for both cars. And we'll actually do so and see if we can maintain the gap even on low fuel use. And it seems to not really be a problem. We're still gaining a little bit of time. Probably gaining less. But we are still gaining 4/10 last lap. Let's see how this lap compares. 6/10. Bit 5/10, so yeah. We gain about half a second each lap. I'd say that's very... very acceptable. So, again, just allow things to progress. We can go balance it for a while too, because we actually ended up with extra fuel while I was having a look at the laps. I was focusing a bit much on that.
Okay, there's a big crash.
Big crash, but no safety car so far.
Fastest lap.
Let's see who had an accident. Verstappen.
We're just watching the Red Bull. A definite collision there. That's very
locked up and probably wrecked his front wing on the wall. Not too surprising, all things considered. First wave of pit stops is done for the soft runners. Well, some of them might have pitted a bit early too, so They are definitely on a two-stopper, as we are, I think. Now, the pit window has been entered, but we're going to burn these mediums a bit, I think. There's no shame in doing so. So yeah, we'll push a couple more laps just to be safe, and we'll be pitting probably Doohan or Piastri since he's in the lead first. And then we'll pit Doohan on the next one. So we'll just do it now. We have enough tire life to play with there. Shouldn't be an issue. There we go. Piastri's pitting. Let's get Doohan's pit stop lined up too. And then we should be good. Came out together as we hoped for. But I don't think we'll have too much of a taking here. They won't level that much. But that's perfectly okay. We have half a minute after our first pit stop on third place, which is kind of nuts when you think about it. 37 now since everyone has done their first pit stop.
It's a stonking lap.
We keep on setting fastest laps, which is also good. So Doohan is getting left a little bit behind here. We'll just have Piastri go conserve. Hopefully that'll allow Doohan to catch up. No, it's the back markers that are currently causing some. There we go. He's back up behind Piastri. Weaving through the back markers that are causing some problems for us. Gasly's doing well. He's up in fifth, but he, I think, pitted early. He's probably going to have to pit once more. And it looks like we're about to lap another large portion of the field, which has left Piastri 2 seconds behind Doohan. Which is, again, a bit disappointing, all things considered. But we can easily make him catch up again, so it's no biggie. Now, what I'm tempted to try and do here, actually, is lapping the whole field. If we can lap everyone, that would actually be quite amazing. We'll probably be able to do it before our final pit stop, but if we stretch these hards towards the end, I don't think we'll be able to do it. So we're going to have to pit and then see if we can gain that pit stop back. But judging by how the 50 laps here have gone, that should be doable. And of course, it's very doable when Science is currently pitting. So this is going to be an awkward one, for sure. Yeah, we're living life on easy mode right now, which is kind of sad, really. I'm really looking forward to that first balance patch. Hopefully it will, give this game some more life again, but I think we're going to do a realistic playthrough where we limit what we can do and cannot do. Again, not using intents for one, using presets, and in general, just, putting some limits on ourselves to make the game a bit more interesting. Did Piastri lock up there and fall behind, or did something else happen? I've actually completely forgotten the pit stops here, so let's get Piastri in first on softs. Shouldn't be a problem. And then we'll get Doohan in the next lap. I think it's fine to just let them run their own race to some degree right now. Now, Leclerc and Sainz unlap themselves, but the big question here is, there's 11 laps left. Can Doohan catch up to Sainz and Leclerc and relap them with what time is left? We'll have to see. This could be interesting. No safety car. Looks like it is doable to some degree. We're gaining about a second each lap, so we'll gain 9 seconds. Lap time is 1:16. So yeah, we'll be around there. Ricciardo crashed.
Daniel Ricciardo involved here.
Ricciardo. Thank goodness nobody else. Basically a carbon copy of Verstappen's crash. So we'll have to see here if we can, you know, make this work. Oh, Leclerc did something silly. Seems to have been a lockup. Leclerc locked up. Understandable. Tires are severely overheating. We don't really care, honestly. But it looks like we'll lap the entire field. Which is honestly a bit disappointing. Yeah, we have lapped the entire field. We'll allow them to deploy all of their ERS and all of their fuel now to do push laps for fastest lap. Although we probably have it already.
And this is the last lap. Check the DRS.
There we are. So we lapped the entire race. That's a yikes moment, honestly. That's straight up domination. So our fastest lap, 2 seconds faster than Ferrari's fastest, Leclerc on a one stop. Yeah, we're gonna power through the season, check out research a bit, do a little bit of testing on other things, and we'll probably do another campaign afterwards that will be a bit more realistic, a bit more challenging. But yeah, if you push everything to the limit, you can basically, you can probably do it faster, but in 1.5 season, you can get a Williams car that no one can really do anything with, which is kind of disappointing. But yeah, thank you for watching. I hope you've enjoyed, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.